Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So right now is 1 a.m. November 14th, 2016. Tonight is one of the so-called supermoons. Basically, the moon is at its full phase and closest approach to the Earth, so it's a few percent brighter than usual. But still, this is the perfect opportunity to test something that I've always wanted to know, and that is whether or not moonlight shining on a solar panel makes any sort of power. So, I've got a little multimeter right here. Let's hook it up and find out. Okay, so it looks like we're getting about 270 millivolts off of the solar panel here. If I let some of the light from this flashlight get on there, you can see the voltage increases to 0.4 volts. And I pull this away, so it's just the moonlight, I get 2.70. Now, let's see what happens if I move this solar panel so it's no longer facing the moon. Just lay it down on the ground here. That'll be fine. Okay, looks like 0.6 millivolts, basically zero. So that means we're definitely getting something from the moon. Excellent. Let's see what happens if I hook it up to a bigger solar panel array. You might not be able to see it, but up there on the roof of the shed, I have 1,800 watts worth of solar panels. Let's go tap into them and see what we get. Now, that was a shooting star. That was cool. I don't think I've ever caught one of those on camera before. But anyway, the amount of energy that the sun is putting out is roughly 400,000 times greater than what the moon is putting out right now. Well, maybe 380,000 times greater. But it's still a lot more. I mean, this is actually just reflected light coming off the moon. Okay, so I've unhooked the solar panels from the battery bank. Here are the two wires, positive and negative. Okay, this is just the power come off the solar panels. It's 1.7 volts. Let's see if I can get some short circuit milliamps out of this. 0.11 milliamps. And that's for a short circuit. So, not very much amperage. So this right here is the smallest light bulb I could find. It's rated for 1.2 volts. Let's see if I can power it off of this solar panel. Okay, that's a nothing. Which I guess I would expect, because it also takes 0.3 amps to power this. Let's try an LED. Okay, put the LED in line. And we also get nothing. And that's probably because the voltage is just way too low. I think this LED requires at least 3 volts to operate properly. So, what could I actually power using this type of power arrangement? Well, how about a digital clock? Let's hook this up, just like this. Okay. Ha! There we go. Using moon power. I've actually lit up this little clock. It's being powered from the moon. That is awesome. So I can actually run something off the solar panels when they got moonshine on them. But still, I want to see a light light up. So let's see if I can figure something out. So the first thing I thought of was, why not use a capacitor? Charge it up to the 1.2 volts and then stick this light bulb on there. Unfortunately, the capacitor wouldn't hold the charge long enough for it to heat up the filament to this incandescent bulb. But I still think I could make it work with the LED light. So I've set up a simple voltage booster here in which I'm hooking up these capacitors in such a way that I can charge them one at a time and increase the voltage step by step. It's kind of cumbersome, but it should work. If I can get this up above 3 volts, it should light the LED. Okay, moment of truth. Let's see if it'll light up. For just a second. Oh my gosh. There it is. Moon-powered lighting. Oh man. Well, that was fun. Hope you all enjoyed. I'll see you next time.